direct negotiations in between farmers and CEOs to kind of terraform the earth by means of carbon agroforests, and to create an unedited and continental scale horn of abundance, churning out everything humans need, and making all humans thrive. What carbon agroforests produce will replace everything else, including all industries, including seemingly unrelated industries, as also the petrochemical industry. Further, all what industries produce or deliver will be renewable, and consequently the process can and will be perpetuated. It is a true perpetuum mobile, except there is solar energy added, but that solar energy is emitted by the sun independently if someone uses it or not. For those who think this perpetuum mobile is irrealistic, or too good to be true, we like to remember, and clearly illustrate and proof in this video and channel, that this perpetuum mobile always existed and always worked like this. We humans only are blind for it and negate it, and are systematically putting it aside, and even literally systematically are degenerating and destroying it. In fact, all fossil fuels, which are clearly ancient, were the result of this same perpetuum mobile. Humans seem to forget that fossil fuels are nothing else but carbon dioxide that was removed from the atmosphere in a deep past. This carbon dioxide that was removed in the past and that was energetized, or in other words was made into a fuel, by means of vegetation, often forests or related to forests like plankton also is, this in combination with sunlight. All today produced carbon agroforest biomass can be used to create superior and non-toxic fuels. This in a matter of an hour or certainly less than a day. The hereby used processes are well-known and well-established processes and techniques, with a long history of use. All products and fuels provided by carbon agroforests will be renewable and perpetuate. So you, in the case of production of the here mentioned renewable and superior gasoline, the carbon agroforests kind of removes or kind of drills the carbon dioxide directly out of the atmosphere. And next the carbon agroforests transform the by it sequestered carbon dioxide into pre-fuel or gasoline, and with some well-established processes and techniques, into the carbon agroforest pre-fuel or carbon agroforest pre-gasoline, that next will be transformed in superior and obviously renewable gasoline. The carbon agroforests run on locally by the agroforests produced renewable fuels and electricity. The same as with the superior gasoline is the case for all products that normally are produced by the petrochemy industry. Contrary to the petrochemy industry, the in carbon agroforests involved installations and industry is not polluting and does not produce bad smells, simply because it uses fresh natural and often aromatic biomass and materials, and not the kind of fermented or rotten biomass, that also is heavily intoxicated with toxic minerals, which after all mineral oil or crude oil is. In the case of carbon agroforest fuels, gas or hydrogen, once they are oxidized like in hydrogen fuel cells into water, and in combustion motors back into non-toxic and non-polluting carbon dioxide, the carbon returns to where it came from, and that is the case of carbon forest fuels to the atmosphere, ready to be used again and again, and this all for free and renewable, including the fuels and electricity eventually used in the processes which go on in or aside the carbon agroforests. The same thing happens with foods and fertilizers, where the most important building block, which is carbon, and which was removed from the atmosphere as carbon dioxide, next will return to it. Even materials for cars, solar panels, and batteries, as well as all building materials when demolished, after eventual cycles of recycling, will return to where they came from, except with some more delay. Again, in a non-agroforest economy, none of the mine fertilizers will return to where they came from, which are the mines. In fact, and seemingly kind of ironically, fossil fuels, including crude oil, are nothing else than carbon dioxide that was kind of drilled from the atmosphere by means of vegetation and plankton, with plankton being a kind of vegetation as well. The process of the South American forests and vegetation removing or drilling the carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere is what you indirectly see in the NASA video on your screen. The green flickering, or rather the part that the green part of the flicker went away, represents the total removal of the carbon dioxide level that is presented in the NASA video. Only well-known, established and efficient processes are used. Once we decide to produce everything with the help of the biomass produced by carbon agroforests. Very different from the slow and extreme crude oil forming process in the earth crust. the in-carbon agroforests used well-known and established processes will use materials free of toxins, and work and produce a wide variety of materials and products that are all free of toxins, and all this processing and production takes place in hours or days. Instead of the millions of years that it has taken for the ancient biomass to become the toxic crude fuel we today know and drill as fossil fuels. This and other videos on this channel have been translated and or dubbed into more than 5 languages, including the official languages of the 9 Amazonian countries, this to support this initiative and plan to unite the 8 billion inhabitants of the planet around this action plan for carbon agroforestry, generating important jobs and boosting the economy. If you'd also like to support this initiative, subscribe to this channel, leave a comment, ask a question, or like this video.